Now let us understand about the storage efficiency, right? Now the word storage, it actually belongs to the root zone depth, right? Now what is actually happening is that, let us say that this was a ground, okay, this was ground, this is a crop, okay. Now before doing irrigation to this particular land, so this crop had some water requirement, right? Let us say that this is the field capacity. Right? This is the permanent wilting point. And let us say that this soil before irrigation, it had some moisture content. This was some moisture content, right? Okay. Now you can see that you can see that this much of water can still be added to soil to meet its demand of field capacity, right? So this is the maximum water which can be added to this soil sample or this particular soil. Now you have done irrigation, but it is found that this level has not gone to the field capacity, but it has reached somewhere here. That is your Y. And let us say this was your X. So you could add X, but you have just added Y. So your efficiency, neta, will be equal to Y divided by X into 100. So that is what I have written, right? That is the amount of water in root zone after irrigation. So after irrigation, this much was the water, right? Okay. Divided by the amount of water required in root zone before irrigation. So before irrigation, this much water was required to go up to the field capacity, maximum water that was required, right? So this is known as the storage and efficiency, right? I hope that you have understood by this diagram what is storage efficiency, okay? Now let's move forward and solve one small numerical based on the storage efficiency also. Thank you.